Hello, it's Sara. I figured I would do a craft room share today. I cleaned my space and I'm very proud of it and I want to share. Quick story though, this is our basement. That's where I craft. And I've crafted for years, and my little desk has been over there for a while, and I had wooden shelving and not too dissimilar from what it is now, but the basement gets wet from time to time. So what happened was I went away to a bead fest seminar type place and made this here. It's a polymer clay. I was into polymer clay at the time. That's Lori Micah. She taught the class and she does shrines and all different. This is a polymer clay art tiles, I guess they would be considered. But all right, so where am I going with this? Anywho, while I was there, my mom had passed away. That's a sad part of the story. This basement was filled with boxes and piles of bags and all types of stuff, and you couldn't even get to my craft area. And while I was away, my husband and my kids cleared it all out. They picked everything up and put it at parts of it in the attic and all that. We've been through it since then and really organized it. But I came home and I was so excited because I was ready to get to crafting again. And what we did was we took down those old warped wooden shelves and I went and got these industrial black. They have these, actually, these two I got at Target. And luckily, I did that first because, excuse me, I don't want to make you sick. That one over there, and there's one behind that on the wall behind it, are from Home Depot. And they're much wider and wider both ways. They wouldn't have fit here. But these ones from Target, look at that. They fit perfect. It's like the perfect width of my desk and fits perfect over there. So I was so happy. Anyway, I've had it now like this for, I don't know, I guess the end of the year. I think I did this back in October. I probably went to the craft show or to the bead show. Anyway, so here it is. So I went industrial. So, and that helps now. So I keep, because down there it is a bunch of notebooks and paper products that at least they're up off the floor like a couple inches. I don't know if that's high enough, but at least it's not going to warp the whole thing won't get warpy. Anyway, so I went with these industrial things. So over here we have my mounted stamps are up there. And I have stamps there. That's pretty much all my stamps. I think I have a few more up on the other shelf. That's my polymer clay oven and my bind it all. And in here, I just wanted to show you. These are when I was doing polymer clay. I like these. This is a mold. But these could be cool embellishments, and I never think of it. But there's tons of them in here. I was really into the art tiles, polymer clay art tiles for a while. See, that's what started me getting stamps. That's what it was. Because I would stamp into the clay. So that's kind of what started the stamping thing. So then, and it snowballed from there. So anyway, so that's that little section. Then you come around here, and this is my beading area. I have all my beads. In here there's some dimensional stickers in there and my stick pin stuff, buttons, and this is lace, like little pieces, bigger pieces of lace, my laminating machine, my paper towels and some brushes. That's my, there's my sign, and that's my little pegboard. I've had that for forever. So up here at the top, I painted for years. So, I mean, I'll just show you, that's cool. That's a seminar I took too. And all the pumpkin-y stuff and the Halloween stuff's up there. My black cat's in the back. And see, there are some more stamps up here, a couple more. Lots of brushes, a few flowers and things. These paints, my Lemur paints that I have not used yet. Any ideas what to do with them? I saw them because Rach had to get them. My sprays, my Copics, dominoes are back there. Here's my Cuddlebug stuff and my dyes and type stuff like that. My Cuddlebug. I like these because, I mean, actually, I think these might have been on clearance at Michael's. And I needed some color over here. I'm a pink girl, but I'm not totally pink. I like color. And that holds like chipboard, like specific things. I don't even remember actually, because I should redo these. I have to redo these again because there's scraps in there. I know what this is, and I haven't colored with my Copics in a while, but what's that paper? Nina cardstock. Anywho, so, and then these work really good for, this is all my metal embellishments type stuff, Tim Holtz-y stuff, bling, flowers and chipboard, scraps, this is my bags and envelopes, let's see, this is bags, this is envelopes, a couple of other, like, alterable things, this is a few stamps are in here, my, this is just for wrapping and stuff in case I ship something, my big, you know what that is. I do have the ribbon thing, and that it's pretty good. I like it. It's pretty filled, and when I start to run out of them, I guess I'm going to have a bunch of empty spools up there. As you can see, there's a lot of examples of what I do hanging around. I did do a share on that one. I don't think I've shared any of my vertical paper bag minis. That's a vertical paper bag mini. This is my embossing powder, and some, there's lots of, there's some embossing powder in here too, and glitter. I just want to say that angel right there, I'm going to zoom in. She's covered with fabric. That swirly print is fabric. So you cover the whole thing with fabric, and then you trace the pattern on and paint on top of it. I've made a couple of them. She's the painting one. That's why I left her down here. But I have other ones in the house that are not painter angels. They're just normal angels. And I painted that. So that's my granddaughter. So yeah, so there's some stained glass. I don't know if it's too bright. There it is. I've done the stained glass stuff. You know, a little hanging stuff of my altered dominoes, my altered bottle caps, and this is my go-to stuff, my go-to tools that I use on the regular basis. This is just like glitter pens. I have a couple of gelatos in here, but like mostly just tools that I do go to on a regular basis. Mostly my rulers are here. Here's my gelatos. These bins are just for like, that's for canvases because it's the stamps, my go-to stamps for canvases. This is just like all my steampunk stuff that I just finished up working with. And then my stickles. I always use Q-tips. I've used Q-tips since I used to paint because they're just good. Like if you get a blob of something, you can just swoop it up real quick. They're good to have. And toothpicks too, because sometimes, I don't know, you just need to poke something for some reason or use it for something. My adhesives are all right here. This is just like a ribbon, more like lace ribbon remnants that I have that I might go to before I go into the stash of them. This is open bling, and this is just like, I just bought these things, which I love to alter these. You just put a little piece of paper under them and you can use them as embellishments. And there's a couple of washi tapes. I need more washi tape. There's an altered tray, printer's tray of my granddaughter. I think I did a share of that. And then up here, that's like canvases, my paint brushes, and paints that I have had for forever. And then there's some memento inks in there, the little teardrop ones. And there's my tapes that I use for different things, different types of tapes. That's lace and ribbon again in there. And that's just where I keep the extras of all my glues and different stuff like that. This is cardstock and K and Company, mostly paper. And then this is just like scrap paper that, you know, instead of leaving it on my desk, I just quick put it in there. This is actually like a light chipboard and a couple chipboard things. This is just newish stuff that I've gotten, like stamps. I just ordered these. I haven't used them yet, so I haven't really put them anywhere. I bought these because I was going to make another YouTube sign. Ooh, we're at 9:35. Gonna make a part two. Oh, I gotta ship these today. But it all started with this because mine was so grungy and disgusting. It was a Fiskars one, and it was like purple and blue. I think this is gonna shut down, so I'll be right back. Okay. So I had a 50% off coupon, and these were actually on sale anyway, so I didn't get 50, I only got 40. But I got the pink one. I got the breast cancer one, and right under there is the breast cancer ribbon. So it's pink on both sides, and I love it because I do like pink. I like to have pink accessories if I can help it. I ended up getting a Smashbook, which I'm a little excited about this because I knew about Smashbooks and they were out there and everything, but I didn't know. So now I'm watching YouTube videos of smashing. So, and it was pink and it was on clearance at Joann's. So I got it. So I'm happy. Something new to play with. All right, let me go into my drawers. Oh, this desk, by the way, this is an office desk. And I think we got it for about $75. It was, I think it was like some type of like office clearance, warehouse clearance thing or something. And I liked it because of the big top. It has a huge surface top. And some desks you get, like little desks for computers or even, you know, they're just not that big. So that's what I loved about it. And it is, it's industrial, so I'm going with that theme. This is all metal, so it being in the basement, it's good because it's not going to warp. And so I'll show you. This is, it's so neat and tidy right now. It wasn't like this yesterday, but my inks are in here, my Stazon, my Tim Holtz distress inks, and my pads and all that. And then down here is like a filing, my stencils, I have felt in here. And my printables, any printables that I have, just random papery stuff. Then this is my 6x6 inch pads. They're in a basket in the front. And then over here is my paper cutter, my ATG gun, my stapler, my refills for my ATG, and blades for my gun. And then down here is, I have, these are cool little stackable bins, and I have like my bling trims, and underneath is just like random stuff like sponges and rubber bands and all more office type stuff. My hot glue gun, I have duct tape in here, and my heat gun. And what else? Okay, so I just wanted to come over here and show you. Oh, this is, I just got this from Michael's. And I decided to hang all my stuff on it. As soon as I saw it, I was like thinking, although I do love this piece for that, because that was actually from my sister-in-law and she was throwing it away, and I put it up, and I didn't, before I even knew what an altered domino was, I just took it and used it. But now I hang stuff from it, so it's pretty cool. And that's another good thing about these metal racks, is you can hang things from them. You can get hooks and just hang things from them too, so it's pretty cool. Then I forget the name of the company that used to sell a similar item. This is actually just a shoe rack, and I think I got it at Target. This is for all my, I don't have a ton of them, punches. I mean, I have enough. It's filled. I guess I have a lot. But that's a shoe rack. So that hangs right, see, like you can just hang it right from the side of it. So that's another good thing. This is, like when I go to, I'm going to be going to, it's not a, what do they call them? Not a, a scrap. What do they call, a crop. It's not a crop. It's a, it's Camp Wanna Stamp. My local scrapbook store is having Camp Wanna Stamp, like not this Sunday, next Sunday, I think. Might be this Sunday. So I like to display my stuff as best I can. Oh, by the way, these baskets that you see here, I also made those. I wove baskets. A woman actually taught them, this one too. She taught right out of her house. And see that one? This one holds magazines, and I think it's empty. Uh-oh, I think I need to use this. I need to utilize that. It's one of my faves. But anyway, so here, let me just back up. Polymer clay in there, my pasta machine, some scrapbooks I've made lately. This kind of, that holds like nuts and bolts type things, like wire and magnets and stuff like that. There's my bicycle stick pin holder that I made. So I just like display little things I've made, my domino books. Oh, let me show you my Santa. This is my Santa. I made him, let me see if there's a date. 03, I went to a seminar and I brought him and I entered him into a, I don't know, whatever contest type thing, and I won a ribbon. So my husband says I'm an award-winning artist now. That's a Maxine Thomas pattern though. I did not design that. I just follow the techniques of how to paint it, and it's her design. You trace it on, it's her line work, and then I just did the techniques to like make it look fluffy and hairy and furry and all that stuff. So anywho, here's some stained glass stuff we made. My husband made this one. No, actually, I made them both, didn't I? He made an airplane one. So here's where I keep my paper. I have tons of paper. I have way too much paper. I don't need any more paper. Can't find my 8x8 graphic 45 pad. Now that I cleaned the room, I kind of lost it. And then I just put this up today. It's one of those foldable ones, and I found that I'm like, oh, let me put this up here. And just displaying more stuff, and I can hold more paper packs because this is just like overflowing. And actually this, I'm sorry if I'm making you sick. This is, I'm starting to use this now. This is holding tags. This is scraps from old Curiosity Shop. This is my graphic 45 scraps, and these are polymer clay stuff too. Polymer clay stuff that I just like didn't love. I put it in here. And graphic 45 stuff, and this one broke, but that was actually my mom's, and I never really used it, and now I'm starting to use it because it's definitely usable. oh look, it's a mosaic I made. This is made out of glass, like the kind of glass that you would use for scrapbooking, for stained glass, sorry. And you just cut it and glue it down and then grout over it. So it's like a mosaic. And I didn't have a lot of colors at the time, as you can see, because I probably would have done darker greens and lighter greens to make it, give it some depth, but I just used what I had. I'll show you my other one too. Where's my snowman? Oh, sorry, I don't know. There's my snowman. I like him. And I put birdies on the bottom. But that's just a piece of wood that I had already that we would have painted on in the past because I used to teach painting. And that's just some more of my stuff, my art tiles that I've made. There's, my mom is on that one. Oh God, my hideous canvases that I hate. And that's about it. There's my, what is that? A something tray. I forget the name of it. And then I painted this bag too. See, the National Society of Decorative Artists. And look at him. This is a little elf wind chime. You buy the kit and follow directions and you paint it. So, all right, guys, I'm gonna back up. Let me push my chair in. I hope I'm not making everybody sick. But I really wanted to share. I was just so happy and proud of my little space. I love it down here. It's quiet. I have my TV if I want it. And if I don't, which I don't for the most part, I'm just in heaven. It's my little piece of heaven. So I just thought I'd do that for you today. And thanks for watching. Bye-bye.